One can only dream. Mike, I don't really have dreams, right? In terms of like when I'm asleep. But when I do, the ones that I remember anyways, inevitably they're about football, right? Yeah, I mean, of course you'd love to, think about something like that. Nobody's reached out to me. But I think to be a part of the appeal to coming back and coaching, and that's why I stay involved with, even high school kids at this level, not necessarily as a coach, but on a, as a like in the private kind of sphere, working with kids off the field. But like being a part of something like that, it's real. When you go off into the corporate world, I'm in sales. It's ironic because like any corporate environment, if they're talking about an initiative or a goal, an agenda, what do? They use sports analogies, oftentimes football analogies. We got to push it over that goal line, you name it, right? And that's what you miss is like football is real, it's true. So I think that'd be super excited to be a part of something, but no, nobody's called me. I'm too much of a liability, Mike. I talk too much. It makes for good pod, but if I was ever on staff at any school, I'd almost like ask to not speak to the media so I could keep myself out of trouble. I can't help but be honest.
Yeah, GAs are usually pretty guarded from that. Okay, as we continue to
Well,
scroll.
Laurinaitis was up on the mic quite a bit. I mean, he was
No,
up.
I don't think so. Maybe once.
I saw him more than once. I mean, you know
Okay.
better than me, but continue to stir. What's up?
What if you get that call? I mean, because Laurinaitis seemed to be doing really well for himself in radio, right? I don't know what else he did besides. I just know he had a
Did
radio
he have his
show.
own show though on
Yeah.
YouTube?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know what his YouTube presence was, but he steps from that role into coaching, and obviously you're not really making much money as a GA, but then the upside of being, a future linebackers coach, position coach, that's the point you're making, what, six figures, and then a defensive coordinator. Now you're making, in the 400, 500,000 range. The money's good, notoriety is good.
All those numbers you just cited are in reality, they're double. But yeah,
I'm talking low end, right?
sure.
Does
Do
that
I
interest
take that
you? Does
phone
that pique
call?
your interest? Yeah,
Of
like
course it
what?
does. Yeah, of course it does. Like I said, one can dream. I would never, I could never envision myself ever being a play caller or a coordinator ever. I almost don't trust myself that much, but in terms of teaching kids and like maybe somebody could teach Maris how to like reduce and slip a block and things like that. That's what I teach my kids on the side now. And I kid with them all the time. I'm like, man, I'm the best coach ever. It's like anybody ever told you that before? We all laugh, but I'd absolutely take that phone call. I mean,
What would you be like as a recruiter?
that's interesting. So I could say this when we talk about having a motor on the recruiting trail. And as we go, I feel like I'm auditioning now or interviewing Mike, but
You are.
talk about a motor. Some guys are lazy. A, Michael, I don't play golf, never have. And B, I'm in sales. If I could tell you and share stories where, I pursued an opportunity or pursued an account for years, right? That ultimately means less to my bottom line than securing a Jalen Snead, if you will. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
You're talking about hours in the car. You're trying to chase an opportunity. So like I tend to just kind of have a inherent motor. And I think like I said, I've been dealing with young people for the last 15 years on the side. And I think the kids that I've worked with kind of bears itself out. I've had some studs that, you kind of took them out of obscurity. Most recently, that offensive tackle, he's got his 13th offer now.
That's awesome.
Yeah. So.
Drunk Vigo says the moms of the recruits would love Goolsby's rugged good looks.
If you say so, it can't hurt. I'm sure, yeah. I mean, I think that's absolutely a thing. I mean, every little, I guess it's an accumulation of little things that end up being a big thing. But yeah, whatever you could do.
I guess what I'm trying to do here by stirring this pot is
Sure.
speak this into existence, and then we get to break this news on the Mike Goolsby Show, the final episode of the Mike Goolsby Show. That would
Yeah.
be awesome.
Yeah. No, it'd be like I said, it'd be cool. I mean,
It would be a great
it's
reason to stop doing the Mike Goolsby Show.
I've always been looking for one. No, but I'll tell you, man, there's like, it's like, you know, and I've realized that as I've gotten older and older, you know, being 40 now, like when I talk ball, I could be exhausted, you know, haven't slept for a day. And like, I still, you know, it's like, you, it just, I light up. So yeah, it'd be cool, but you know, you got to kind of pay your dues. I don't know any of those guys. I guess I know a couple of those coaches on staff, but I don't see that phone call coming, but it's fun. Fun to think about.
All right, everybody, just keep tweeting. Tweet about.
Yeah, write your senator. Write your senator.
Write your senator. Tweet hashtag Mike Goolsby to ND.
Ghouls Mike. For GA, dude. Ghouls for GA. Hashtag Ghouls for GA. Come on, Mike.